This is Tazin from Don Bosco Institute of Technology. And since we are affiliated to the Mumbai University, we follow a similar pattern. But to a great extent, we also use the Moodle for posting our course material, for even posting our question bank. We even hold online tests for the students. So like, it's a bit different. Like we do follow the university so that nobody else points out to us that we are somewhere not following the university pattern. But along with it,
management has made it mandatory for all the faculty members to conduct at least one test on Moodle. Yes.
So like we have to compulsorily conduct a test on Moodle. We have to post our course materials. We even keep like offline activities, like students post their questions, we answer to them, or we even keep it, you know, after the hours of the college period during
a this, because this Moodle must be a relatively recent development.
Sir, we are using since 3 years.
3 years. Do you remember how it was 3 years ago? Basically, from the perspective of, do you feel that use of Moodle has enhanced the effectiveness of your teaching and students' learning?
No, sir. Not that.
So, in
so,
what way do you find it is useful?
In your introductory lecture, the first day, that day you said one title, that changing the mindset of student. That is very difficult to, means it's not in faculty's hand to change the mindset of student. Actually, they do not take it seriously. If, let's say, if we are conducting quiz on the Moodle, let's say there are 30 questions, they will come, they will just, if multiple choice questions are there, they will just click on any of the options and they will submit it and submit the answers. But they won't take it seriously. That is the biggest
observation.
Yes.
But does it help at least in consolidating the learning material and making it available at one place?
Yes, definitely.
As far as
So the reason for not taking it seriously is because we are, as of now, affiliated to the Mumbai University. So the students' mindset is that they just have to give their exam and clear it out. So if we, in the future, we plan to become autonomous, it could cause a lot of help to them.
So for example, if for the in-semester quizzes and tests, the weightage was 80% and only 20 marks for the final written exam, then you think the attitude will change
obviously,
completely?
Definitely. It would change. Yeah, but considering the term work.
So this is good thing. What is the batch size you have and what is the number of students?
Per batch is 25 students for practical.
For lab?
Yes.
Okay. And
class it is 60 to 65.
60 to 65. And how many students are there per year?
Around 250.
250.
Yes.
So you have again four batches.
Yes. Sir.
And how many four teachers are involved in teaching this?
Yes.
And lab also the same four teachers.
Yes.
Yes.
The same pattern that we saw there. Yes. One teacher taking three lab batches or what? Mm-hmm. Wonderful. And the mundane things like blackboard and chalk is.
So we use blackboards. We use whiteboards in the labs. Then we have OHPs in every classroom, and LCD we have per department. So like. The ones who want the
So here is the question. How many teachers use OHP routinely and how many teachers use Blackboard routinely? It's a question of...
So it actually depends per subject wise. Like if there is a programming subject, it's there would be no sense in using transparencies or slides.
I see this as the third time that observation is being made, that if I have a theory subject, I can use slides. But it's a programming course, then there is no sense in using slides. We have been teaching programming course using slides for 30 years. So we would like to understand what is the difficulty and we would like to share with you how we think it can be used. Yes.
Hello everybody, I'm Dipti Jadhav from IIT College, I've been teaching CP1 from last 2 to 3 years.
What sir asked is, like we also in our department, we have 2 to 3 OHPs as well as we have LCD projector. But when I insisted on carrying an OHP, what I was the feedback is the students are too small, or they are like they have just come from the 12th to the engineering course. So teaching them on OHPs is too fast for them, or it is too difficult for them to grasp. So it's better that you write on a blackboard so that they can jot it down and they will be, it will be effective for them to learn because they have been doing it since they were in the school and in the colleges. This was what the other teachers or my seniors have suggested me.
Okay. Because since you have the mic, can you tell us how many students are there in IIT?
First year we have an intake of 420 students and we have 6 divisions.
6 divisions?
Yeah, for the first year.
So about 70 students per
Yeah, 70 students.
How many lab batches you have?
One class, like one, we have 6 divisions, so one division has been divided into 3 batches, of 25 to 30 students, you can say, which are mix of all the branches.
And how many teachers do you have? Do you have 6 teachers teaching?
No, we are, at present we have 3 teachers who are taking, yeah, one teacher, 2 classes, 2 divisions.
And labs?
Same, we are self taking it.
God bless you, you have so much load.
I just wanted to one point to that. I'm Professor Vidhate from same college, Ramrao Adhik Institute of Technology. Belongs to Diva Patil Group. With that, even TAs are available at our place. We have a BG course in computers as well as electronics. So TAs are available to assist in laboratories. Rest theoretical part and plus some part of practicals these people used to handle.
Since we are teaching in the college, in the class, we know we have what we have covered.
Yeah.
So we are with them, with the TAs
no,
to assist
no problem
them.
There. We also do the same thing, but TAs are required because the load is more actually.
Yeah, the TAs are there.
Okay.
Along with this, the TAs.
So you have TAs there. But
yeah.
The examination pattern is same exactly
same,
as the university.
We have 4 hours of teaching lectures and 2 hours of practicals for every batch.
4 hours per week.
Yeah.
But I was told CP1 sometimes only 2 hours per week or something,
no.
Something like that.
Probably for a
VJTI it is a different way, it is autonomous. We are in the Bombay University.
I see.
So 4 hours or minimum like 3 to 4 hours is given per week and 2 hours of practical every batch.
2 hours.
Uh-huh. We have a complete dedicated lab.
I have not understood this because two other people also said that 4 hours per week is scheduled.
Hmm.
And we have mostly, sometimes it happens 4 hours, sometimes it happens 3 hours. Similarly,
no, by
75 or 60, but 40 to 50 hours are conducted.
Yeah, one syllabus it is 3 hours only, that was a mistake was shown us for that. That was 3 hours only per week. So into 14 weeks, that is we come up to 42 hours.
Yeah, my question is very similar. This is something which my IIT mindset can't accept. If there are going to be 42 hours, there have to be exactly 42 hours. There can't be 41.
It
can't be 40.
It is 42 only, but because of the holidays which comes in during the semester, it may reduce.
So you don't do the simple timetabling jugglery. That, for example, in a semester, let's say there are too many Thursdays as holidays. Then what we do is, we run on some Friday or Thursday timetable. So we equally distribute all weekdays, ensuring that not more than one weekday is a holiday in a semester. Yes, I'm just suggesting that to ensure that you have an equal spread. However, do you as teachers actually count the number of hours exactly that you have? And at the beginning, do you have a plan as to what you are going to teach in the 32nd lecture?
Before the semester begins.
And that is because of the university pattern which prescribes that you should have so many hours.
Before the semester becomes, begins, we have to submit our total syllabus, lesson plan, what we call. We have to submit it to our HODs, like what are we going to cover in what lecture.
You also have similar observation about students as he mentioned, that students do not necessarily take these lab assignments and all very seriously or quizzes.
No, I think it is depends upon the faculty, like how serious you are with the students about doing the assignments. But one thing to tell is, like the Bombay syllabus, Bombay University syllabus regarding the first year is like covering C as well as C++. It is too taxing for the students. So, and covering 25 practicals when already the batch has started late, because since the admissions takes place late, the students start very late in August.
Oh,
so it becomes very difficult for the students. Like at the end, we are like, it's a pity for the students to cover 25 practicals at the end. So like we have to help the students a lot.
I would like to one point to this, sir. In Mumbai University for first semester, this is a very common problem.
Yeah.
Normally, college used to start in month of August itself. And they hardly get, some 10 weeks to complete the things. So for first semester, this is a very common problem.
It includes as much as 40% of that?
Around.
So, even though the semester starts late, 1 month later, 15 or 20 days late, so
So, so many number of extra week is given at the end for the first semester only. That means the total number of weeks in the semester remains 14 only.
Actually, it may not be 14, but it may not be as bad as 10. The truth will be somewhere in between.
Yeah, here is 12 to 39.
A few colleges by running, you know, this extra lectures on Saturdays could be covered, sir. Even we do that, sir, actually. We do it on every Saturday.
Okay, I understand. And you
we
also
have a dedicated lab completely for the FE practicals.
Hmm.
Like, and we have a dual boot.
Dual boot, you know.
Yeah.
So you would be comfortable running this with Linux environment?
Yeah, we
run with Linux only, sir. Linux. We have a SUSE Linux, that environment.
Well, whatever Linux you have, this is not a problem.
Mm-hmm.
The other question I had is that, like, so you already mentioned that mostly you tend to use Blackboard in the classroom.
Yeah,
in the classroom. Okay. Fine.
Just I want to add one more submission to this, sir. As far as the setups are concerned, we have web servers and all, you know, hosting and will be done by our people only, their local place. And as far as the Moodle and everything, those portals are concerned, it can be deployed there itself and students can use it after working hours also.
Correct.
So
that's the purpose. Our Moodle is
that's
used
true.
By people in the nights from the hospital.
Yeah, because that much scalability we have in our environment, what we maintain.
If I put my slides there, even if I am using Blackboard, it is useful to prepare slides because slides become a recorded version which people can see even later. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks a lot.